Dear students, the topic of this lecture is Jahn Teller distortion and electronic spectra. So how Jahn Teller distortion is going to affect the electronic spectra? So it affects generally the width of electronic spectra. Because of this Jahn Teller distortion, the width of spectra of transition elements, it is very broad. So now, first of all, we have to discuss about the Jahn Teller distortion. So in case of Jahn Teller distortion, a non-linear molecules, it may be an octahedral complex. That octahedral complex, so this is the free ion. So in this case, this is a free ion. So when this free ion, it forms an octahedral complex. So it is an octahedral complex. We know that during crystal field splitting, this during formation of this octahedral complex, this 3D, the degenerate orbital, it splits into two orbitals, that are T2G and EG. So this is an octahedral complex. This non-linear octahedral complex, in a degenerate electronic state, it is unstable. So it splits into T2G and EG set. Sometimes this octahedral complex has octahedral symmetry, OH symmetry, that is higher symmetry. So sometimes this octahedral symmetry, it undergoes a kind of distortion that lowers its symmetry. It lowers its symmetry, and thus it can distorts, and it cannot remain degenerate. T2G set cannot remain degenerate, so it allows a lower symmetry. So it again splits into different orbitals, like EG can split into dx square, y square and dz square, and T2G can split into dxy and dyz and dxz orbital. So this is a kind of elongation in octahedral complex. If the z ligands, they far away from this central metal atom, then this position occurs. One other distortion of symmetry may be compressed type. So in that case, compressed type means in octahedral complex, these two Z ligands, they come closer. And in elongation type, these two ligands, they go far away. So this is elongation of bond at Z direction, and this is compression of bond in Z direction. So why this lowering of symmetry occurs? This lowering of symmetry occurs when the EG set is asymmetrically filled. Generally, T2G may also be asymmetrically filled, like T2G 2, T2G 1, T2G 4, T2G 5. These are the asymmetrical filling of T2G orbital. While in case of EG1 and EG3, they are asymmetrically filled orbitals. So when these orbitals, they are asymmetrically filled, then their degeneracy removes. They remove their degeneracy, and they split into their respective orbitals. So generally this occurs when higher amount of distortion will occur when EG is generally EG is asymmetrically filled. So this is known as Jahn Teller distortion. Jahn Teller distortion means this T2G set and EG set, they lower their symmetry, and after lowering their symmetry, they split into their orbitals. So this is the lowering of symmetry. So lowering of symmetry, it removes the degeneracy of electronic states and attain lower energy. So some orbitals, they attain lower energy, and some attain the higher energy. Generally, the molecules, overall the molecule, it attains the lower energy. In case of, so we can say that this is the case of T term. So this is the T term because T is asymmetrically filled, and this is E term because this electron can be arranged in dx square, y square or in dz square. So this is E term. So in case of E and T terms, Jahn Teller distortion can occur. So if the ground state or excited state it has E or T term, then Jahn Teller distortion occurs. Okay, so for example, we can see the case of TiF6 3 minus. So in case of TiF6 3 minus, Ti3+ has D1 configuration. So D2 D1 configuration, because it has T2G1 configuration, so Jahn Teller distortion occur, and then this T2G set will split into two sets of orbitals, that are DXY and DYZ and DZX. Likewise, in case of D6 configuration, if D6 is high spin, then again, in case of D6 high spin, the electrons will fill like this, T2G set, then here, then here, then here. So again, T2G is asymmetrically filled. So distortion occurs. Distortion means this degenerate orbital, it can lose its degeneracy, and it remove its degeneracy and distort to lower symmetry molecule. So this is known as Jahn Teller distortion. So now we can give the name to these orbitals. We have given it to EZ, B2G, A1G and B1G. So how we can name these orbitals? First we have to give the name of orbitals. So name of orbitals can be given on the basis of their symmetry. In case of EZ orbitals, so these DXZ and DYZ, these two orbitals are they remain degenerate during lowering of symmetry. So their name is EG. E means doubly degenerate. So they are doubly degenerate orbitals. Their name is very simple. That of DX square and Y square. DX square, Y square is an orbital having the highest energy in case of elongation. So in this case, if we see this orbital, if we rotate this orbital around this axis, so we will find that this minus will come to this positive part, and this positive part come to this minus part. So if we rotate this orbital, so this this axis at z direction, at an angle of 45 degrees, so we will find that their wave sign, they changed. So that means that the axis of symmetry is not there. So its name becomes B. So it is B. And if we cut this molecule through this principal axis, then we can see that it can cut into two parts which are mirror image of each other. So we have given this 1. So 1 means it is symmetric with respect to plane of symmetry, and B means it is asymmetric with respect to axis of symmetry. So its name is B1G. Now come to dz square. Dz square, in case of dz square orbital, if we rotate it through z direction, it will give the similar orientation. So the name is given as A. So this is the A orbital, and 1 means if we cut it through this principal axis, we can cut it into equal parts which are mirror image of each other. So its name is A1G. 1 means symmetric with respect to plane of symmetry, and A means symmetric with respect to axis of symmetry. In case of DXY, so in case of DXY, if we rotate through this Z axis, then we will not get the similar orientation. So it is B. And if we cut it through this principal axis, we cannot get the exact second two halves which are mirror image of each other. So it has no plane of symmetry as well as no axis of symmetry. So the orbital's name is B2G. And now we can see that how this Jahn Teller distortion, it affects the width of an electronic spectrum. So we can explain with the help of these examples. So this is the example of D6 configuration. So D6 configuration example may be CO F6 3 negative. Its electronic configuration is D6. So in case of D6, because this T2G set is asymmetrically filled, so Jahn Teller distortion occurs, and due to this Jahn Teller distortion, this orbital B B2G and B2G this T2G split into B2G and EG, and this EG split into B1G and this A1G. So electron, now in this case, if it will be octahedral complex, then only one transition will be there. Electron will transfer from this T2G to EG. But due to Jahn Teller distortion, this electron can excite from B2G to B1G or from B2G to A1G. So now you can see that there are two apparent transitions. So in spite of, if it will be an octahedral complex, then only one transition, only one peak should appear in its spectra. But due to this splitting, due to this Jahn Teller distortion, there can be two transitions from here to here and from here to here. So due to these two transitions, we can see that there is a hump, and we can see that this is a peak, and we can get another peak that is a shoulder. So we can find a broad peak in case of, in spite of a sharp peak, we it seems that there are two peaks in its spectra. So this is due to these two transitions. Again, we can see another example of D1 configuration. So in case of D1 configuration, due to asymmetrically filling of this T2G set, this again lowers its symmetry, and there are chances of two type of transitions. So in spite of getting only one peak, there are broad peak. There is a broad peak, and this peak is with a shoulder at 17,400 centimeter, in addition to a peak at 20,300 centimeter inwards. So this is a shoulder which is due to Jahn Teller distortion. So due to Jahn Teller distortion, actually the width of this peak, it increases. Likewise, we can see another example, that is D9 configuration. So this is D9 configuration. It is a copper complex, and in this case we can see that this splits into two peaks. So we can find that in spite of one transition, there may be possibilities of two transitions. So this is not the possibility. Actually, this may be the possibility of transition of electron. This is not the possibility. So one is from here to here, and another is from here to here. So these two possibilities may occur due to Jahn Teller distortion. And here, in case of copper, there is a strong Jahn Teller distortion. So strong Jahn Teller distortion due to asymmetric filling of electrons in EG set. So this spectra of this complex is like that there is a shoulder with a main peak. Likewise, this Jahn Teller distortion may occur in D1 configuration of tetrahedral complex also. So we can explain it with the help of this kind of splitting in case of octahedral complexes. So in VCl4 also, due to D1 configuration, there are two transitions. There may be possibility of two transitions. So in spite of one transition, there may be two possibilities of transition. So it's a spectra also, it is like a broad spectra, and there is a hump in this in the peak of this D1 configuration VCl4 complex. So this is how this Jahn Teller is effect, it affects the width of a transition metal spectra. So in case of transition metal complexes, the width of D1 configuration, D6 configuration, D9 configuration, D4 configuration, they may be broad, or they may have a shoulder along with the main peak.